गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द इंडस्ट्रियल स्टाइचियोमेट्री एंड द टॉपिक नंबर 5, फ्यूल एंड कंबशन. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर वील सी द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्यूल्स, वेदर इट मे बी सॉलिड, लिक्विड और गैसियस फ्यूल. देन वील सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू. इन दैट वील सी द NCV एंड GCV, नेट कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू एंड ग्रॉस कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू. Then combustion processes, complete and incomplete combustion, and finally we'll see the composition of flue gases and the requirement of air for the completion of your reaction. Now there are different types of fuels and different types of fuel which comprise the solid, liquid and gaseous fuel. Fuel is a material such as coal, LPG, CNG, gasoline, etc., which is after burning produce heat or power. In the process industry, the fuel is burned in furnaces, may be solid, it may be liquid or gases. A furnace is an enclosed space in which heat is produced by the chemical oxidation of fuel. And there are three different types of fuel, solid fuels. Coal is a mixture of carbon, hydrogen and non-combustible ash, water, sulfur, coke, wood, bagasse, charcoal. Then liquid fuels which is principally hydrocarbons obtained from distillation of crude oil, and such as kerosene, petrol, diesel, methanol, biodiesel, etc. And then the last one is the gaseous fuel, and principally natural gas, which is usually contain 80-95% methane, and the balance being ethane, propane and small quantities of other gases, light hydrocarbons, acetylene, LPG, biogas and hydrogen, etc. Now let us see the calorific value of the fuel. This calorific value of fuel is also known as the heating value of fuel, and is the negative of the standard heat of combustion and expressed per unit mass of fuel. Since the standard heat of combustion is always negative, the calorific value is positive. The value is a fuel which is defined as the total heat produced when a unit mass of fuel is completely burnt with pure oxygen. And after the burning of fuel, the hydrogen in the fuel reacts with oxygen and it gives the water. And when the water is present into the flue gases as vapors, the latent heat of vaporization is lost. That means the heat associated with water vapor is getting lost, and hence this quantity of heat is not available for any useful purpose. So the net calorific value, or the NCV of a fuel, is the calorific value of fuel when the water in the combustion product is present in the vapor form, that is minus delta standard heat of combustion with water as one of the combustion product. The latent heat of vaporization of water can be made available for useful purpose if the water vapors are condensed. And the gross calorific value, or higher heating value of a fuel, is the calorific value of fuel when water in the combustion products is present in the liquid form. That is, it is equal to the net calorific value of the fuel to which the latent heat of water vapors, that means the latent heat of condensation of water vapor, is added. So the gross calorific value obtained is the addition of net calorific value and latent heat of vaporization of water vapor. So the NCV and GCV of the fuels are usually reported at 298 degree Kelvin, and must be expressed in kilojoule per kilogram of fuel, kilojoule per mole of fuel, or sometimes kilojoule per meter cube of gaseous fuel. And to calculate the net calorific value of fuel from the gross calorific value of the fuel, we must calculate the moles of water produced when a unit mass of fuel is burnt. So the GCV is equal to NCV plus N delta HV, where N be the mole of water produced, where delta HV is the latent heat of vaporization of water in kilojoule per mole. The GCV calculated will be the kilojoule per mole if the M is the quantity of water produced in kilogram when a unit mass of fuel is burnt, and lambda is the latent heat of condensation of water vapor at 298 degree Kelvin. Then GCV and NCV of a fuel in kilojoule per kilogram of the fuel are related by GCV is equal to NCV plus M lambda, or sometimes GCV is equal to NCV plus in the bracket weight percent hydrogen 9 into lambda divided by 100 kilojoule per kg. If the fuel under consideration is a mixture of combustible substances, then its heating value is given by formula summation of Xi into HVI, where HVI is the heating value of the ith combustible substance. When the heating values are expressed in units of energy per unit mass, then the Xi's are the weight fractions of the fuel components, and they are expressed in unit of energy per mole. Then Xi is the mole fractions of the fuel components. So the proximate analysis of coal involves the determination of moisture, volatile matter, ash and fixed carbon. And the ultimate analysis of coal involves the determination of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur and oxygen of a coal. The oxygen content of a coal is obtained by deducting some of the percent of elements other than the oxygen from 100. Then the combustion processes. There are two processes, complete combustion and incomplete combustion. I think all you know about the complete and incomplete combustion. Complete combustion will occur when there is enough oxygen to allow the fuel to react completely to produce the carbon dioxide and water. And in case of incomplete combustion, the product of combustion contains carbon monoxide and carbon as a soot in addition to CO2 and water. In incomplete combustion, it is not desirable as to produce lesser amount of heat as well as poisonous CO gas as compared to complete combustion. The combustion reactions are given. C plus O2 gives CO2, complete combustion. And if the propane is there, then after complete combustion, thrice CO2 plus 4H2O is there. And for partial combustion of propane, we get the CO and water. A flue gas is the gas existing to the atmosphere via a flue. So the flue pipe or channel that is necessary to carry the exhaust gases from the furnace boiler to the atmosphere, and it consists of CO2, CO, water, excess oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, nitrous oxide and sulfur oxide. And the percentage of air pollutants such as particulate matter like CO, nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide, sulfur oxide is very small. Now see the requirement of air. For the complete combustion of air, mostly we have to supply the, for complete combustion of processes, particularly we have to supply the oxygen. But instead of supplying pure oxygen, we have to supply the air, and we air contain 21% oxygen and 79% nitrogen by volume. So the, if we compare the stoichiometric coefficient or stoichiometric requirement, we'll supply the air in excess quantity. So there is a terms like theoretical oxygen or theoretical air and excess air. Theoretical air requirement in moles is given by theoretical oxygen requirement in moles divided by 0.21, as 21% air is available in the air. Oxygen is available in the air. And the excess air can be calculated like percent excess air, which is equal to actual air supply minus theoretical air requirement divided by theoretical air requirement into the 100. And finally, actual air supply is equal to theoretical air requirement in the bracket 1 plus percent excess divided by 100. So if you know the feed rate of the fuel and the stoichiometric equation for complete combustion of the fuel, you can calculate the theoretical oxygen demand or requirement and air feed rate. And the equation for the calculation of percent excess air cited above is applicable for calculation of percent oxygen, excess oxygen. In this way, the excess air requirement depends upon the type of fuel burned. Gaseous fuels requires very less excess air. Liquid fuel require more excess air than the gaseous one, and the solid require higher amount of excess air than the required for the liquid fuel and gaseous fuel. Gaseous fuels are burnt with 5 to 15% excess air, while liquid and solid are burnt with 10 to 50% excess air. And the amount of excess air is to be calculated based on the calculation of fuel that can be burned. So in this way, we have seen the fuel and combustion. Thank you.